Hello everybody, this is Walmart Killer, and I'm playing the Stanley Parable. I believe this is going to be part 4, and we're going to resume. We just took this elevator down after taking an alternate universe to, like, the boss's room, but it was a different boss's room.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door
really.
That read Mind Control Facility.
I bet everybody says hell no, and goes with the escape written with crayon on the side. I don't know what to do here. Okay.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Sweet, let's do it. Violent death coming up. Can I run? Can I run to it?
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Is this one of those hallways that doesn't end?
At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Okay. Wow, like, that wouldn't kill me?
As the machine whirred into motion, and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man. So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
What?
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
Whoa. Okay. Why is the narrator a chick now? What the hell?
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
Let's get a screenshot of that, because why the hell not? And wow, we can't go back at all, it's only forward. Look at this.
When every path you can
so
walk
weird.
Has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now?
What?
Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
What? I'm dead? Oh, I want to play that game. Okay. That probably really is that dude. Kevin, I bet that really is his name. Oh wow, now they got like pictures of the hallways and stuff, the boss's office. I've never seen it look like that or that. I've seen this one, but I haven't seen the other one. Like the first time you go there. Office clock, what the hell? This goes up. Doesn't go to that spot there though. Oh, let's check this out. What's this? Narrator outtakes.
Where were all of his co-workers? Oh, I don't know. How about they're throwing a surprise party for him for all his buttons.
sound plausible to you? See how it's impossible for the player to do anything in this room. Perfect example.
Okay, that's really strange. I guess we're gonna go back and go up here. We'll see where this takes us. Freedom ending. And the game's alpha. Yeah, that room. Interesting.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another.
Huh?
How they both wish to be free.
Really weird, really weird. Let's get another screenshot.
Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now, and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let time
Well, I wasn't gonna, no, actually press escape there. Is it gonna restart? Is it gonna restart? Hello? Okay. Quit to menu. That's what you wanted. That was weird. Is it gonna restart everything now? I don't get it.
This is the storm.
Yeah, I'll skip that. I wonder
how
if it
long
restarted
was I sitting
everything.
There? Stanley wondered to himself. Minutes? Days? Centuries? Did something crucial happen while my senses were turned? He made a note to be more careful with time from now on.
I don't think he said that before.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay. We'll be the Boy Scout and do what he wants this time. See what happens.
Yet, there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Hope coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Yep, let's do it. Boss's office. Hello, boss. What up, G?
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf, looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to his situation. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Okay. Yeah. I got this part. I've done this. But I'm playing with all your rules this time. I'm following all the rules this time. Such a weird game. Yep. What do you want me to do now, narrator?
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
All right, let's do this shit.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Well, sure I do. I'm Stanley. I'm Stanley, fool. I got this. Okay, now what? I'm here. Oh, this thing.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Okay.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Well, I don't know.
No, he refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible?
Was it really?
Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content, walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place.
Mind control.
And as the
offline.
Cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Hell yeah. Now how do I do that? Okay. I'll fuck your machine up as soon as I figure out how. Well, I guess this is the power room, so I guess be in there, right? Just was looking around at other stuff first. I thought maybe there was... Oh, it's not a big stupid button, is it? Okay, apparently that one button did nothing.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power... He knew it was his duty. Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you?
Yep.
After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted?
Yep.
Control?
Yep.
Oh, Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system.
What?
In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode.
Nuclear? Really? Is it that necessary?
How long until detonation then? Say, 2 minutes. Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going. What all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated? All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I
turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside,
what?
Or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though, this version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock, why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now?
Well, there's that.
Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons, no, these colored ones, or maybe this big red button, or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? Stanley, you're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless, to see you made humble. This is not a challenge, it's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't.
Well, bye-bye.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here. Just
why would stuff shake?
Pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice.
5-2-1, huh?
Make it count, or don't. It's all the same to me, all a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily ever up.
Was he for real? Did he just kill me? Again? This guy's an asshole. He's worse than GLaDOS.
Someone was following Stanley. He was sure of it. If he checked over his shoulder now, he would surely catch them. It was only a matter of time.
Ain't nobody following me. It's weird. Let me in the 420 room. I need my weed.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
No.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. The lounge was sublime, a work of art. What was it but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
No. No.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Screw you. Screw you.
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death.
That's right.
Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
I'm super powerful and then probably super dead. But super powerful just the same, you little bitch. Oh, it's dark now.
When
wow.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
No, screw you.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
I'm gonna see if I can kill myself again.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first time understood true happiness. Then the feeling went away, and he felt sad again. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
No. Can I kill myself again?
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, but in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death.
Again.
Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
That's because I am really powerful. You don't even know. You got no idea, bro. No idea. Huh? Seriously?
Good morning. Thank you for contacting the Future Happiness Foundation. We are confirming your shipment of 1,327 cardboard boxes to your place of work. Can you verify that this is correct? Excellent. Your order will arrive shortly. Thank you again for contacting the Future Happiness Foundation.
Wow. That phone has never done anything before. Okay. Well, I think we're going to do that for today. That's going to be all. Died a couple times. Died a lot of times. But, you know, it's different every time. Let's see if we can make something different in the next episode. Later, guys.